We are told in the xy plane which of the following is a solution to the system of inequalities above. And they give us four choices, and we need to pick one of these. So pause this video and see if you can work through this. All right, now let's do it together. Now, the simplest way to do this is to just test each of these coordinates on each of these inequalities and figure out which of these coordinates is true for both of these inequalities. So for example, choice A here, where x is 0 and y is 2. Remember, these are xy pairs. So we could test it with that first inequality. Is it the case that 2y is greater than 1 half to the x power? In this case, x is 0. Is this statement true? Well, 1 half to the 0 power is 1. So 2 is indeed greater than 1, so it meets the first inequality's constraints. And let's look at the second one. Is it in fact the case that y, and in this situation y is 2, that 2 is less than negative 1 half times, in this case, 0 squared, plus 2? So let's see. If we have negative 1 half times 0 squared is just 0, so this whole thing's going to be 0. So is it true that 2 is less than 2? No, 2 is less than or equal to 2, but it's not less than 2. So this coordinate pair right over here does not meet the constraints of this second inequality. So we can rule this one out. This is not true. Now let's look at this choice. When x is 1 and y is 1, does that meet these two constraints? Well, let's see. Is it true that y being 1 is greater than 1 half to the x power? In this case, x is 1. Well, 1 is indeed 1 half to the one first power is just 1 half. So this is true. 1 is greater than 1 half, so it meets that constraint. And let's look at the second one. Here, y is 1. So is it the case that 1 is less than negative 1 half times 1 squared plus 2? So let's see this. Let's see, negative, so 1 squared is just 1. And so negative 1 half plus 2 is going to be 1.5. So it is the case that 1 is less than 1.5. So this coordinate pair right over here, it met both of these constraints. So I like that choice. And if I was taking the SAT and if I was under time pressure, I'd be done. But we can verify that these two also won't meet these constraints. So let's see. When x is 2, y is 1. So let's see. So 1, in order for this to meet the constraints, 1 would have to be greater than 1/2 to the 2 power, to the second power. So it is true that 1 is greater than 1/2 squared is 1/4. So it meets that first condition. The second one is it the case that 1 is less than negative 1/2 times 2 squared plus 2? 2 squared is 4. Negative 1/2 times 4 is negative 2. Negative 2 plus 2 is 0. So this whole thing becomes a 0. It is not true that 1 is less than 0. So this one doesn't meet the second condition. And this one over here, if we have, let's see, if y is 0, is it the case that 0 is greater than 1/2 to the third power? That's that first condition there. And we can immediately see that this is not going to be the situation, because 0 is not greater than 1/2 to the third power is 1/8. 0 is not greater than 1/8. This is not true. And so we don't even have to go to the second condition. We can rule that one out as well. But as soon as we saw that B met these conditions, we should feel good about it.